Chapter 30 of Pinocchio by Carlo Collodi. This LibriVox recording is in the public domain. Chapter 30 The Land of Boobies. Pinocchio, as was natural, asked the fairy's permission to go round the town to give out the invitations, and the fairy said to him, "Go if you like, and invite your companions for the breakfast tomorrow, but remember to return home before dark. Have you understood?" "I promise to be back in an hour," answered the puppet. "Take care, Pinocchio. Boys are always very ready to promise, but generally they are little given to keep their word." "But I am not like other boys. When I say a thing, I do it." "We shall see. If you are disobedient, so much the worse for you."
"Why?"
"Because boys who do not listen to the advice of those who know more than they do always meet with some misfortune or other."
"I have experienced that," said Pinocchio, "but I shall never make that mistake again."
"We shall see if that is true." Without saying more, the puppet took leave of his good fairy, who was like a mamma to him, and went out of the house singing and dancing. In less than an hour all his friends were invited. Some accepted at once heartily, others at first required pressing, but when they heard that the rolls to be eaten with the coffee were to be buttered on both sides, they ended by saying, "We will come also to do you a pleasure." Now I must tell you that amongst Pinocchio's friends and schoolfellows there was one that he greatly preferred and was very fond of. This boy's name was Romeo, but he always went by the nickname of Candlewick, because he was so thin, straight, and bright, like the new wick of a little nightlight. Candlewick was the laziest and the naughtiest boy in the school, but Pinocchio was devoted to him. He had indeed gone at once to his house to invite him to breakfast, but he had not found him. He returned a second time, but Candlewick was not there. He went a third time, but it was in vain. Where could he search for him? He looked here, there, and everywhere, and at last he saw him hiding on the porch of a peasant's cottage.
"What are you doing there?" asked Pinocchio, coming up to him.
"I am waiting for midnight to start away."
"And where are you going?"
"I am going to live in a country, the most delightful country in the world. A real land of sweetmeats."
"And what is it called?"
"It is called the Land of Boobies. Why do you not come too?"
"I? No, never."
"You are wrong, Pinocchio. If you do not come, you will repent it. Where could you find a better country for us boys? There are no schools there. There are no masters. There are no books. In that delightful land nobody ever studies. On Saturday there is never school, and every week consists of 6 Saturdays and 1 Sunday. Only think, the autumn holidays begin on the 1st of January and finish on the last day of December. That is the country for me. That is what all civilized countries should be like."
"But how are the days spent in the Land of Boobies?"
"They are spent in play and amusement from morning till night. When night comes, you go to bed and recommence the same life in the morning. What do you think of it?"
Said Pinocchio, and he shook his head slightly, as much as to say,
"That is a life that I would also willingly lead." "Well, will you go with me, yes or no? Resolve quickly."
"No, no, no, and again, no. I promised my good fairy to become a well-conducted boy, and I will keep my word. And as I see that the sun is setting, I must leave you at once and run away. Good-bye, and a pleasant journey to you."
"Where are you rushing off to in such a hurry?"
"Home. My good fairy wishes me to be back before dark."
"Wait another 2 minutes."
"It will make me too late."
"Only 2 minutes."
"And if the fairy scolds me?"
"Let her scold. When she has scolded well, she will hold her tongue.
said that rascal Candlewick. "And what are you going to do? Are you going alone or with companions?"
"Alone, indeed not. There will be more than 100 boys."
"And do you make the journey on foot?"
"A coach will pass by shortly, which is to take me to that happy country."
"What would I not give for the coach to pass by now?"
"Why?"
"That I might see you all start together."
"Stay here a little longer, and you will see us."
"No, no, I must go home."
"Wait another 2 minutes."
"I have already delayed too long. The fairy will be anxious about me."
"Poor fairy! Is she afraid that the bats will eat you?"
"But now," continued Pinocchio, "are you really certain that there are no schools in that country?"
"Not even the shadow of one."
"And no masters either?"
"Not one."
"And no one is ever made to study?"
"Never, never, never."
"What a delightful country!" said Pinocchio, his mouth watering. "What a delightful country! I've never been there, but I can quite imagine it."
"Why will you not come also?"
"It is useless to tempt me. I promised my good fairy to become a sensible boy, and I will not break my word."
"Goodbye, then, and give my compliments to all the boys at school, if you meet them in the street."
"Goodbye, Candlewick. A pleasant journey to you. Amuse yourself and think sometimes of your friends." Thus saying, the puppet made 2 steps to go, but then stopped. And turning to his friend, he inquired, "But are you quite certain that in that country all the weeks consist of 6 Saturdays and 1 Sunday?
"Most certainly."
"But do you know for certain that the holidays begin on the 1st of January and finish on the last day of December?"
"Assuredly." "What a delightful country!" repeated Pinocchio, looking enchanted.
Then, with a resolute air, he added in a great hurry, "This time, really goodbye, and a pleasant journey to you."
"Goodbye."
"When do you start?"
"Shortly."
"What a pity! If really it wanted only an hour to the time of your start, I should almost be tempted to wait."
"And the fairy?"
"It is already late. If I return home an hour sooner or later, it will be all the same."
"Poor Pinocchio! And if the fairy scolds you?"
"I must have patience. I will let her scold. When she has scolded well, she will hold her tongue." In the meantime, night had come on, and it was quite dark. Suddenly they saw in the distance a small light moving, and they heard a noise of talking and the sound of a trumpet, but so small and feeble that it resembled the hum of a mosquito.
"Here it is!" shouted Candlewick, jumping to his feet.
"What is it?" asked Pinocchio in a whisper.
"It is the coach coming to take me. Now will you come, yes or no?"
"But is it really true," asked the puppet, "that in that country boys are never obliged to study?"
"Never, never, never."
"What a delightful country!"
"What a delightful country! What a delightful country!"
End of chapter 30.